This is the Michael Smerconish Program.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. I'm Michael Smerconish. My in-studio guest is such a special guy that he wrote this song for Dr. Evil.
What if God was one of us? Just a slug like one of us.
Can you picture this scene in the movie, Eric Bazilian?
Absolutely. This is indelibly ingrained in my consciousness.
Come on. It was a hysterical moment.
It was a historical moment.
Yeah.
I knew it was coming. I'd obviously been told about it, but it was, I knew that it was going to be in the film. I didn't know how it would be used. And I remember that the day before the film came out during one of the premieres, my publisher called me afterwards. He left me a voicemail. He was hysterical. He said, I'm not going to spoil this for you, but trust me, you're going
to
love it.
Do you remember going to the theater and watching it and seeing it?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, that day. And it's such a surreal thing, you know, with Mini-Me sitting on top of with his own. But, you know, there was in all the Austin Powers movies, there's a precedent for everything he does. Sometimes it's very obvious, like the way he references The Prisoner. Or James Bond movies,
right?
But there's actually a precedent for the little piano and the little guy on top of the.
What is it?
It's the Island of Dr. Moreau. With the later version with Marlon Brando and Michael York, in which Michael York is wandering about on the island in unauthorized territory, and he happens upon Dr. Moreau's lair, and at this point, Marlon Brando is enormous and his head shaved. He's wearing this white muumuu thing, and he's sitting at this white piano, and on top of the white piano, there's a little tiny white piano, and the Rat Boy. Rat Boy is this little genetic hybrid that he's created. The whole premise of the movie is that the Dr. Moreau, who's, I won't say evil, but in questionable moral ground, is creating these human-animal hybrids. And there's this little tiny Rat Boy, who really is the precedent for Mini-Me, sitting up there, and they're both playing the piano.
I loved it. I thought it was hysterical. And how does that work? Did they call you and say, may we use this? They have to license it from you?
Yeah, they have to license it.
And the gauche question, do you get paid?
Yeah, actually, for that I did, yeah.
We never know what the rules are around here. I'm going to play a lot of Hooters music, mm-hmm. a lot of Eric Bazilian music during the course of your visit here today. I always wonder, how many seconds am I allowed to play before we're on the hook to somebody?
Oh, zero.
Really?
No.
We owe you money already.
Already, right, just talking about it.
Hey, not only did Dr. Evil, I just think that this is one of the best songs ever written. Oh. And I don't just mean by you, and I'm just not sucking up to you, even though I think you're my new best friend. But when Joan Osborne did her version of it, and it sounded a little different than Dr. Evil. I don't want to talk over it, but when it kicks in,
Yeah, it's
one of those things where you reach for the radio in the car and you just crank it.
It kind of cranks itself, so you get the double crank effect.
Yes.
I'm about to do my stage move here. I can't help it.